half the country gets, like, crushed or something.
Hello and welcome to Anya with Odin, Game Mastering Pathfinder Dragonfall. This week, well, as the title says, big pit is big. So we're going to keep going through the pit of the Shadow Goddess. Hopefully reach the end today. By the way, actually, everyone needs to make a perception check.
Perception? Okay.
Where does the stream go? It goes here.
Alright, now I have to start trying to remember the stats for this character. Perception, okay. Nope, that's the wrong tab. There we go.
And I'm not seeing jack shit.
Well, I guess you guys are just waking up or something since you made camp in here, I think. I forget.
Hang on, I'm looking at the character sheet.
Excuse me.
What was that?
Okay, Aranam's gonna try and perceive. Whoa!
Hey.
Aranam's doing okay perception. This morning. He's up and chipper.
Hang on, still looking for perception. I know it's on here somewhere.
So yes, this is a new day for everyone who needs to do stuff on a new day. Rising Phoenix! Of course Rising Phoenix rolls well.
Of course.
Alright, so...
Oh wait, let me put it in a better way. Of course she does!
Perception.
God damn it.
It's gotta be on here somewhere. I saw it last time. I'm not making my perception roll for finding perception.
Skills. Skills tab. Go down to the P's.
Yeah.
It's the first one in the P section.
Nine?
Nine? If that's what it says in total, then yeah, nine.
Okay. I have no idea what I'm doing.
It's the first column of the skill is the total. So 14 plus 9,
23. My roleplay buddy's gone. I'm ready to roleplay.
Okay, so everyone's waking up and you guys have pretty much adapted to the heat in here. And in fact, it's kind of nice how warm it is in here when you're trying to sleep.
I don't know what happened to myself.
Because, you know, a lot of the time these dungeons are always just so cold and damp. Oh, wait, this is your first dungeon, you wouldn't know. A seasoned adventurer would certainly appreciate the change of climate within a dungeon.
We're going to be spoiled for future dungeons, you know that.
And it's actually in here that everyone who rolled above a 20 noticed something. Something that's been kind of irritating some people during the night. There's been like a ticking or a clicking inside one of the walls in here. And it's faint, like really faint, but it's been bugging some people when it's dead silent. Which isn't often because there's quite a few like groans and screams going on during the night.
Enfys may or may not snore.
He's mayor may not? I didn't know he was the mayor of a town.
Okay, so Sage Hart heard it, Aranam heard it, and Rising Phoenix heard it. Tuffy did.
I'm gonna mute my microphone a bit because roommate's gonna be making popcorn.
Okay. So, so you hear this? Like, those who rolled over 15 heard it but didn't quite hear what direction it came from. So Tuffy heard it, just wasn't specific. So, also Enfys heard it and Genevieve heard it. Tom, I think, probably just blotted it out after a while.
Yeah.
It's like tick, 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 willpower. Silence.
Oh, man. Sorry. That ticking noise during the night was annoying. Did anybody else hear that?
Yeah, I don't know what was up with that.
Neither do I.
You come from there, and the Rising Phoenix just, like, points, like, lazily just lifts an arm and points over to here.
Huh. Well, I wonder what the hell that is. I'll wander over and, I guess, make a perception check to see if I can find anything strange with the wall. Mm-hmm.
It's just a wall.
Huh, well, I don't notice anything.
Tom will give it a try.
It just looks like a wall to me. Dude, it's just a wall. I guess you can examine it yourself if you want.
Yeah, Tuffy's gonna wander over and be like,
Nope.
Everybody line up.
Tom also believes it's just a wall.
It's just a wall. There's a ticking. Like, this wall is completely normal, but there is a ticking here.
Whatever. It's probably just like a pipe or something.
Wait, did I just roll again? Huh.
I rolled my perception.
Genevieve. You notice that there seems to be some form of, one block of that makes up the wall seems to be a little worn around the edges.
Oh, really?
And then you realize, wait, block? These are all just like solid walls. These aren't brickwork. This is like solid masonry, as in like big one-piece walls. Why is there a block here?
And how the hell did they miss it?
Well, you only, like, slightly notice it because of, like, scrape marks. It's, like, completely flush, but there's, like, scrape marks around a square.
Alright, I don't know if this is a trap or not, so I'm gonna point it out to Tuffy and be like, hey, look at this.
Huh? Hmm? Oh, now you point it out, I can't not see it. How did I not see that? I guess I should try and figure it out.
Has been seen cannot be unseen.
She's gonna get her spider buddy out, and he's gonna try and jimmy out this block or panel or whatever it seems to be. And she gets +5 from using that. Okay, that's actually still fine. She manages to, like, slide out the block, which seems to be, like, a good foot-by-foot cube of stone that comes out and just goes onto the floor. The spider, like, quickly just moves out the way. And inside seems to be a room. And there's lots and lots of gears and devices. And this weird, almost like an engine, that seems to be in the middle of it. And that's kind of where the ticking's been coming from. And she's like, ooh, what's this?
What's this? What's this?
She vanishes into the, disappears into the hidden room.
So that's what was in there. What the hell is that for?
Give me a sec, I'm gonna see if I can check it out. Oh! I know what this is! Okay, you see how this one here is stopped and this one here is stopped, but all these ones are going? As far as I can see from these labels, that's the one. These ones that are stopped here are the traps that I've disabled. So this seems to be some form of like maintenance or main control kind of area for the traps in the dungeon.
That's interesting.
I guess you don't want to be reactivating a trap while you're over the top of it. This makes sense.
So you could disable all of them from here?
Oh wow. That may take me some time, but I can try.
Not like we don't have time.
It would certainly be nice to not have to worry about that as much.
Alright, little spider buddy, let's do this. Still a 16.
It's just 3, like, 19, it's like
disables one, goes to the next one, poing. Oh. Actually, I think I'm going to take a bit more time with this. So he's going to take 20 with this.
Alright.
Yeah. Good old take 20.
It's going to take a while.
You guys have breakfast or whatever.
Yeah.
I have breakfast, make up potions, do whatever we need to.
I'm just going to feed on curiosity and tinkering.
Are we dipping into the
and salt since give my
our rations, or do we have some other form of food still right now?
We've got tiger jerky still.
Okay.
Yeah, we turn it on then.
Use up a little bit more cheese. I'll have to resupply on cheese the next time we're in town. Make up my spells for the day.
And you've cut out.
These are good. Create water, stabilized. Alright. Alright. I'm just gonna meditate for a while, I guess. While we wait for, Dubby.
Oh god, ow.
Hmm?
Nothing, I think, like, I, like, bit slightly wrong and, like, bit the inside of my cheek.
Ah, I hate that.
Yeah, and now it feels like, yeah. Like, eating stuff in the right-hand side of my mouth right now hurts kind of a lot. That's, ow.
Yeah, it sounds ill.
Yeah. What I'm hoping it's not is my one wisdom tooth that wasn't pulled out. Because that would suck having another one of those out.
I was kind of lucky I had all four of mine out at the same time.
I only had three to pull out.
I had one removed because it was coming in sideways. Anyway, so after a while, you hear this, Oh, well, that's easier. Clang!
Sounds like she's having a bit of trouble there.
And then suddenly,
are you okay?
Suddenly all the ticking stops.
Did you just break the engine? That's probably what I would have done.
Sounds like it.
Well, I tried to just disable the engine, but then some of my tools got stuck. Sorry, little guy. And the only way to get it free without damaging him was to whack it. So I whacked it. And now he's free, and he's okay. He's still got all his tools. And it seems that whacking it also made it stop.
Alright. That works.
It's like any enemy. Whack it enough and it will stop.
Yeah, I mean, I thought I disabled a bit, but I guess I just needed to turn it a bit further, and I think the whack did that.
Okay, who wants to make the joke about the whack job here? Because I don't want to.
Okay, well, I'm just going to quickly double check to make sure it doesn't reactivate, because, yeah. And after another, like, 5 minutes or so, she's like, all right, I think I pulled out enough bits from this for it to not work. She's like, doop. Hey, I think it's done.
All right. Woo, already off to a good start this morning.
Good job, Tuffy.
Thank you.
Alright. Oh, we ready to get back on to wandering around this dungeon?
Sounds fun.
Oh, joy. You have no idea how excited I am.
To keep wandering around this dungeon.
There's no sky in here.
Like you saw sky in the dragon.
But I got to see it, and it's out there. I know it's out there.
And that thought should comfort you.
Let's just go.
He's addicted to sky.
It's a myth. Everybody knows
Memphis,
that.
Are you okay?
I'll be okay.
Oh, knock on my door one sec, guys.
It's a myth created by the bourgeoisie to keep the proletariat in line.
Well, God damn it! I'll be the proletariat then.
You are.
I'll tell you why. There's a good film I want to see on at 9 o'clock called The Client, so I'll do that. But, oh no, you've saved my bacon doing that.
Okay, who's that in the background?
I'm not as good.
Out
as
of curiosity.
I can do stuff.
Yeah.
But things
I don't know, but he is so British.
Oh, yeah. Almost sounds like the King of the Gods, actually.
Are you playing other people?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought you said, what I mean, you're... Oh, I couldn't do anything like this.
No, I just got them all on Skype, and this is playing through with this. Yeah, because, I mean, it's just... It's not, like, I've had one a fortnight, and that's how long since the...
Don't worry, because I don't know, so I'm going to get rid of all this shit. But if it happens again, right?
Yeah.
Just, doobry-doobry, just give me a tap, and I've always got bin bags and shit. We'll get rid of it. They emptied them today, so they're all good.
Okay, cool.
Don't worry. No, I'll do this.
And as bad as the boxes are, it's also those that build up. That's
it's cool. We'll get rid of this. Oh, no, that's the least I'm going to do.
Ben, you've cut out.
Yeah, if we say if I...
Or else I have.
Sunday,
no,
right.
It's fine. Definitely not
tell you.
It's
what,
bad.
Yeah, everyone.
We're going to have to dummy run.
Yeah.
Okay, that part I heard.
Welcome back. And it's funny because today is the 20th.
Yeah.
Again, two. And that came through again at 2 o'clock. When I've done the application, I've sent it. I started doing the application at 2 o'clock. And you know what I mean? It's like two seems to be really lucky for me. Like if I go in a betting shop, I always bet on number two.
Yeah.
It doesn't always win, but 9 times out of 10. Does.
The game that I'm running yesterday, the party discovered that they, well, one of them accidentally turned an entire city into zombies.
Whoops.
Accidentally.
Well, at the time he didn't know what the ring could do, but you know.
This is why you throw strange gold rings into Mount Doom.
Has been on the job for 3 years.
It's true.
So that one's only been there 6 months.
Yeah, well, they've got the old girls who want to...
Yeah,
but how do you know if they'll turn you invisible or not?
It just seems to work in my favor.
You don't care, you just throw them in.
But invisibility is so cool.
So, the job's going great. I'm pleased.
Yeah, but you're not totally invisible. There's this one glowing red eye of fire that always knows where you are.
Eh, you'll get used to it.
Reeboks.
I know you're in the bathroom.
Zine.
They're so comfortable. They're
I know you're in the bathroom taking a poo.
Yeah.
And when you run your feet all day, you're
I know what you did in the bathroom. You're disgusting.
If you can, I think if you go in the sports shop up where you are,
yeah.
I think they're going to
see you.
I probably could actually, but no. You're doing your weekend at the moment.
I'm watching you in the bathroom, you shall not pass.
Oh, yeah, it's a monthly that you need to be
650.
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm sorry, I do apologize for that.
£5 tips.
No, that's kind of where I was going with it, but.
It's just disgusting.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome. If there's time for me to take a break, which there usually is around, like, when it calms down a bit, around 2, 3. And then Chris will just cook up.
Not to mention, highly uncomfortable for the person involved.
Well, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's also good that it's zero, so you don't have all the crap in it as well. Yeah. I mean, we've got 4 flats here. Why don't we have 2 recycling bins? I guess we can say to the council, we're 4 households in this building, we need an extra recycling bin.
I'm sorry, I don't broadcast these. I really didn't want to say that one out loud.
It's okay.
Hey guys, sorry about that. It's
It's fine. It's fine. We're all fine down here. Nothing to see.
I know.
We weren't.
Yeah, so my neighbours popped over because, as he said, like even when we put out the bins, they don't always take them. So he's come over to help dispose of my recycling and stuff because they've not been emptying the bin.
I took the bin tonight because I actually thought tonight you'd go over to your mum and dad's for the weekend for the same dinner.
No, the next time I'm doing that is with my brother's birthday over in April. I might even have to do that because of working.
So you told your mum and dad you got your job and that.
Yeah,
yeah,
done all that.
For
yeah, they are very pleased.
Well, listen, mate, this, just stick this until you find what you want there. At the end of the day, it don't matter what, you've got money coming in.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, listen, anything is better than £72 a week, isn't it?
Definitely. Right? Anyway, so you guys are heading out. Sorry.
Are you talking to us or the British guy?
I'm talking to you guys now.
Okay.
And the British guy is David, my neighbor.
Hello, David.
Hello,
neighbor.
David, the neighbor.
Everyone says hi.
Hi, Dave.
Hi. Yeah, just those.
Yeah, because I don't have any black bags, and I need to get some.
It's one of them things, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
Wait,
yeah. I'm about to hoover up properly too. Yeah. Okay, so are we gonna go with the usual? Oh yeah, that's for that. Yeah.
Excuse me.
Okay, so we're gonna go for like the regular marching order. We're gonna have Tuffy and Genevieve, and then have. That there, that there. Oh wait, we've got 2 more to put in.
I said that
song. Why is Tuffy in front?
And then, while we're not in combat, Bruce is just going to be on Tuffy's one. Okay, so last time you guys, like, beat up this wraith and destroyed it and fought some bats and pretty much just gonna carry on. So you do notice that there is the way you came in, and then there's this portcullis here.
Okay, let's go through the portcullis.
Okay. As the typical effect, when you're on this side of it, then there's always a lever. So I'm just going to quickly flip you guys, because it's kind of funny that I put you all in order and then realized that you're going to be going the other way. There we go. And what you see in here is a door here, and this one is a locked door, I believe.
Oh, good thing Tuffy's in front.
Hell, that's why she goes in front, because she's useful.
Oh, wow.
I have an owie right here.
I meant for traps and locks. Okay, so she pops the lock.
Tuffy goes in front because she's useful. Unlike the rest of you scripts.
Four locks and traps, etc. God damn. Guys, I've been at work today. Give me a break. You know what I mean. So yeah. She opens up the lock, and what you see is a exceedingly strange creature. Let's see, I need to look this up, one sec. See if there's any flavor put in for this. Doesn't look like it. Okay, so what this happens is that, well, pretty much the second the door unlocks, this thing comes straight at you guys. So I have to add you all to.
Roll initiative.
Yeah, I'm just gonna add all of you guys on there.
There's my inish.
Okay, I gotta remember what my initiative is. I believe it's something ridiculous like 8. Yes, it is.
Okay, let's see if I can find.
Good.
It's good having such a high initiative when you're stuck in the middle of the group. I know you can move through them with your.
And my roll reflects that.
I'm looking
for
that
again.
Let's see.
Tuffy's
got
to basically react to this thing. Oh, no, yeah, throw those.
And
I didn't even know
those were
still in there. Bloody hell. And, okay, so that was Tuffy's. Okay, so apparently she's was so distracted by unlocking the door that she's kind of derping for a bit. And let's see, now for Rising Phoenix. Oh, of course. Oh yes, he's not here, so I have to roll for Aranam. And that is, I think it's a bit higher than this. because of his level. Well, it's not, it's just dex, so it wouldn't change because of his level. Because I've still only got his level 1 sheet. That's okay for a plus 3. Oh, wait, no, 14. And now this thing. Okay, and descending. Yeah, because she has insane dex. What is your dex ability, just to mind?
18.
Yeah, hers is higher because of her race, yeah. She has pretty much very basic mental stats, but she has stupid high dexterity. She's actually at 22, which is crazy. First things first. I'm sure. Let's see. I'm just wondering, like, how would this play out? Like, would you guys' reactions, of course, be before the monsters? But like, if the people who are seeing through the door hasn't reacted yet to the creature, then would you guys know and act accordingly? I'm sure you would. It's a reaction to talk. So, doing her usual thing, right? I think it's just gonna, with her axe over her shoulder, just do one move action, so that'll be 25. Just walk straight up to it, pretty much. So, excuse me, dummy.
Alright,
it's just basically, excuse me, pardon me, coming through. Okay, flat-footed, no. Okay, and she misses. The thing is very small and very quick, and has abnormally large hands.
It's getting better.
Much better, thank you.
Alright, I'm assuming since we've been traveling through the corridors, as usual, I've had my sling out.
Yeah, you guys ready? Pretty much know to be combat ready in this place.
Yeah, okay. All right, then I will move 5, 10, 15, 20. I have, yeah, I'll move over here so that way there's plenty of room for people to start getting into position around me since I'm not going to be doing too much. So. And I will make. I'll take a sling attack, which takes -4 for going into melee. So that is going to be, once I figure out where it is. Alright, that'll be a +1. Alright, come on. Not a 1.
Oh! That's not a 1.
You got a 1. +1.
Okay, roll to confirm.
Okay! This is very unlikely at +1, but let's do it. 15.
That confirms.
Awesome! I think it's just a x2 on a sling. Yeah. So that's gonna be 1d4 +3 x2.
Yeah, because despite it only being a x2, you do get your strength bonus to sling attacks.
Yep.
Awesome.
Slash roll, d4 +3 x2. Alright, so. 14! That's one hell of a sling shot.
That was max damage, yeah, that was good. let's see. Okay.
Aw, oh, crap, I pissed it off, and now it's its turn.
Okay. Actually, it's exceedingly bloody right now. Like, you managed to smash into it, and this small apparition-looking thing just is bleeding profusely.
Oh, standing here. I didn't think I'd actually hit it or deal damage, or I would have moved out so that way people could get around me to attack it.
Be proud of something, man. Hit the damn thing.
But this was a tactical decision.
Okay. I know what this guy's gonna do now.
Of course. He'd have to provoke an attack of opportunity to get to me. Unless he has a spell or something. Or range attack.
No, he's actually going to withdraw. Because, yeah, you nailed that guy. He's...
Damn.
And with,
he's gonna fail that one in the morning.
Does withdrawal have to be a straight line again? I forget. I don't think it's...
No, it just lets you ignore the first 5 feet of... So yeah, it's...
Yeah.
I'm pretty stupid. It's just up to double whatever you want.
So he withdraws and seems to disappear into this wall here. And you can kind of hear echoing down what sounds like a corridor, the kind of scrabbling that he's doing to not die, pretty much.
Well, that happened.
So what do you guys do? It's Aranam's turn. Do you try and pursue him through the wall?
We'd have to, like, search and try to find if we can get through it. Then I'm very long gone, wherever it is he's running by then. But we might want to search the wall anyway, just to see if there is a passage there. What do you guys think?
Definitely think that sounds fun.
Alright.
If he went through it, there's probably a passage somewhere.
Well, unless he can just walk through walls.
Yeah. Are we still... We're not still... Oh, we are still...
No, we're out of combat now.
Okay.
I'm gonna actually close this.
So I was gonna move up here and check out this door.
Okay, it's locked.
What you guys are doing? Okay. Alrighty then, that simplifies everything.
You could try using your paladin unlocking system.
Hit it till it breaks.
Let's see.
Smash it with a hammer!
Duffy's searching the wall, looking for any nooks and crannies that look out of place, and she's not finding anything.
All right. Well, we did see him here, Tuffy. You wanna let me take a look?
I really will hit it if you want me to.
Oh, thank you, dude. Oh, is that split on the side?
That's all right.
All right.
Well, actually, it's a big split, so I'll tie it and bring the other side. That's going in.
Okay, yes, you notice that searching the wall does no good. It's in fact the floor that seems to have a route to get beyond this.
Tuffy, you might want to step back for a sec. Just in case.
Hmm?
Well, you said the floor, so I assume, you know, the floor right there.
Yeah.
Oh, right, I noticed it, sorry.
It's Tuffy that went, hmm.
Yeah, so... You're the GM and characters. Confusing to me sometimes. I'm sorry.
I know.
It looks like it's actually the floor here that has the way out. Not entirely sure how it works, but...
Ah. Okay, well, I'm going to try and figure that out. Jesus.
You're the one who's good at these sorts of things, not me.
She just basically just gets on the floor and starts... Like, her and the little grass spider start looking around, looking for an access port. And then find a way to pop it open. Yeah. Really? On these rolls? You find that, like, a very small portion of the wall is linked to the floor and actually comes away to show a... basically a path underneath the wall. Clearly designed for a small creature. But you could quite easily fit through it by crawling, if you wanted to.
Oh god, do we really want to go crawling after something that...
Figure a way to hold your sword out straight in front of you. So it takes up the middle of the passage. That way, if the thing turns around and comes back, it skewers itself.
Or it has a long enough reach that it hits you anyway.
Randy Phoenix just stands there, kind of just the usual. I go where you go.
Jen, what's that door look like over there? Is it locked?
It is quite locked.
What a stupid
thing. Duffy just walks over and just goes, oh, it's pretty much the same as the other doors. Pop. Just pops up. Because she rolled a 20. A 20 on that roll reveals all secrets of the room. Not just where she's looking.
The thought of crawling in an enclosed space like that does not thrill me. I vote for the door. What about the rest of you?
Sure, why not?
It is wise for us to not split the party.
I wasn't suggesting we split. I was suggesting we take a vote on which way to go.
If you choose the door, I will go with the door.
Alright.
Thank you, man. Take care.
Door!
Door it is, then.
Okay. So, we just need to reveal this area. Why is scrolling making me go sideways? Go up. Oh, it's probably because I was holding shift. Okay. So you guys head through this door, and it goes over here, down here, along here, around there. All the way down there. Oh god, what is that noise?
Background music.
Sounds like a kettle boiling.
Oh. I don't hear it.
Does it sound like a loud screeching sound?
Yeah.
I can hear it. I can hear that too. It's coming from...
But you guys can't hear the jackhammer. It's loud enough.
Oh, is that what it
not
is?
Jackhammer. That's wrong. That's the wrong...
It actually is a jackhammer.
Actually, it is, Ben.
Yeah, it is a jackhammer.
Yeah, once it's echoed through, it distorts.
I can see it out the window.
Okay.
It's a jackhammer.
It's just further away than usual.
Yeah, it's down the road a little bit. I can see it that way.
Just loud enough to sit my teeth on.
So, you find this corridor to be extremely long, and keeps going and going and going and going, until eventually it reaches what seems to be a dead end.
What seems to be a dead end right before room number 5.
Yep.
Let's not go that way.
So you decide to backtrack and be like, try the secret door, I guess? It's, yeah.
Well, there might be a secret way to go right from there, but...
Are we going to, since that led us nowhere useful, unless we want to, like, actually, whatever. I'm tired. There's no sky.
Memphis, wake up! You awake yet?
Alright. So...
So before you turn around, Tuffy goes, wait, it's another one of those secret doors.
Yay.
Do you guys want to still go back and go through the crawl space, or should we try this?
Oh.
Try the thing.
I suppose we can.
We can at least open the secret door and see where it leads to room number 5.
So... Tom crawls through or goes through or whatever and scouts.
Yeah, Tom will be the scout.
Yeah, she pops the lock open and yeah, it just leads into room 5 and you're like, oh, didn't know there's a door here.
Haven't seen these guys in a while. How you doing?
They're still dead. Yeah.
Awesome. Let's go.
So that just looped us around. I guess we should go try the other way. I guess is the logic here.
Yeah, I guess we should be exhaustive in our search. Never know when we might find something.
Okay, so Tom will go to the secret door and win it.
Nope, wrong one. Meant to move Tuffy. Okay, you head in and you see that once you're actually through here, it opens up to a full-size corridor.
Tom pokes his head back out. There's a full-size corridor in here.
Oh, alright. Well, it's not nearly as bad as what I feared, so let's just get going then.
God. Oh god, I see where it leads.
Everybody squeeze!
So Tom's leading this time? Okay.
Yeah, Tom's on scouting duty. And...
And then...
Oh. That's right, all the traps are disabled.
Yeah, so like you pause for a bit, Tuffy goes up to it and goes, poke, poke. Okay, that thing I did, it worked.
Perception check. Fuck you. Fuck you, dice.
You perceive that this door, it's open. I did not mean to make that sound so condescending.
I know.
I'm sure you didn't.
It was too perfect.
Dom peeks around. Oh, he's the room full of zombies.
Well,
we haven't killed any of them yet.
Did you want to take
Hang
care of this?
Hang on a minute. Yeah, I got an idea.
The guy just got an idea, Ryan.
Door still... Is that another portcullis type or straight-up door?
The one that the aberration's running for is a portcullis. The one in front of you is a straight-up door.
Okay. I still have an idea.
Mm-hmm.
Zombies don't move too fast, right, guys?
So far.
Okay. I'm going to check my bombs, etc., and so on. We got any oil?
We have some of that fat from the tiger.
That works. let's fling some oil out in that area around the door and stand right in front of it and taunt them to come our direction. When they've gathered up on the oil, torch it.
Then you can smell a burning zombie.
I'd rather smell burning zombies than have them eat me.
Yeah, brains. They like brains, you know.
We're aware of this.
It's okay, Jess. That's why I alerted you it's being recorded.
Trust them to start doing that when we stop playing.
Anyway.
It's like, screw you! Okay, which room number is this? Just so I know.
Peeks around the corner. Again. See, 1, 2, 3, 4 zombies. And the aberration running for the portcullis.
You see the aberration. Like, it's a small size aberration, but it sits underneath the lever for the portcullis, and two large tentacles just grow out of it and lash at the lever to pull it.
Yeah, we're not catching that thing.
Okay, so we have. You also notice that a fountain of water sits against the south wall. There is something written in it, but you can't quite see it from here. On the north wall.
Yeah, my ability to read at a distance isn't all that good.
Well, you guys figure out whatever attack plan you want to do. I'll sling it, things.
I am going to roll a perception check for the zombie as you peek out. Okay, roll stealth. If you want to. Unless you want to just be like, hey, zombies.
Hey! Okay. Want me to roll stealth? I'll roll stealth. Give me a second. Okay. Roll high. That'll work.
The zombie doesn't notice you.
Motherfucking ninja.
In fact, the zombie just doesn't see you so hard that he turns around. And kind of like, you know, the portcullis opens and all the zombies kind of like, ooh, what's that? And he's like looking over the imp. Or the whatever that creature is.
Zombies are distracted. Now is our chance if we wish to attack.
Well, bottlenecking him at the door is an idea. We would be limiting our best melee fighters to only one of them being able to hit and having to soak up all of that. I don't know.
If they have to go through an inferno to reach us, it's going to damage them a lot is all. But, your choice.
As you're discussing, the aberration is just sort of like, zoom, I'm out of here.
I think we kind of gave up chasing the aberration at this point anyways.
You can kind of hear him as he goes down the hall, just go,
oh my god.
Because he's small. He has a squeaky voice.
Alright.
I wish I had balloons at this point. Start putting holy water in balloons and just throwing them everywhere.
So are you guys still figuring out your plan of action?
No. Tom is going to draw his short bow for now.
Okay.
Get it ready. And let's see.
I could run and have them wail on me for a little bit if you really want.
Well, you are wearing the heaviest armor out of all of us.
Yeah, you probably better get in the front.
Okay.
We are ready.
The three of you made it to the front.
The three melee specialists in the front, the rest, everyone else in the back.
Mm-hmm.
That should be a good plan.
And while you're, like, reforming the party, you notice that the zombies basically saw the open door and they're like, ooh, open door, 5, 15, 20, 25, 30.
We're chasing after the damn abomination.
Ooh. That's 5, 15, 30. 5, 15, 20, 25, 30. The zombies have been released. They are now roaming. All of them are holding out their mobile phones in front of them.
Oh lord, now we have free range zombies. Gonna be showing up on our supermarket stores shelves.
I thought the free-range zombies worked in the supermarkets.
I think we'd best take them down now before they get too far to handle.
Sounds good.
Shall we roll initiative again?
Yes.
Yeah, let's do that. Stuff.
Fuck me!
Ooh.
That nat 1 is negated by the fact that you're sneaking up on them.
Okay, just means I'm slow as fuck.
I'm craving Kentucky Fried Chicken for some reason.
Okay, right. So that is that. That is that. Okay. Oh, there's 2 16s.
I guarantee you Rising Phoenix is going first.
Yeah.
And these zombies are so distracted that they didn't even roll initiative. So they're just zeros. Because they don't know what the fuck's going on right now. They're like, ooh, door's open. Yay.
Door's open.
So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30.
Job done.
And what is the, I forget what the range on his staff of force was. I think it's just like a magic missile range.
That would be line of sight.
Well, doesn't magic missile in this have an actual range, though?
Yeah, it's like 100 per level or something. Or is it? No, it's 100 plus 5 per level, I think. So it's ridiculous.
Yeah, it's... Because everything in Pathfinder for spells is either, like, close, medium, or far, or whatever.
Yeah, it's long, I think is what they have.
Magic Missile is orbital.
It's like, there's a bunch of, like, wizards, about 20 of them, put into stasis in a big circle up in an orbital laser. And on command, they all fire a magic missile down at the surface. And it passes through some form of, some form of, like, magical lens that combines them all together into one big magic missile laser.
Silly.
And you just sort of, like, you got, like, this magic wand, you just go, boing, on the guy, and, like, this little, boing, like, flashing red light just lands on them. Orbital launch detected. And you just hear, magic missile, from space. And the thing is, all of those casters are level 20 casters. Hell, you could have the magic missile in area if you just remove the lens. If something is in these squares, it'll get hit. So he's just gonna D3 plus. I think it's just D3 with the regular one. It's the empowered one that has plus.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, I was talking to you. Boom. One damage.
Which one was that on?
You hit the zombie, and he notices.
Oh. What was that?
They're coming to get you, Infus.
They're coming to take me away. Ha ha, they're coming to take me away.
Oh, hee hee, to the funny farm. We're like, this beautiful all the time.
Okay.
Gee, it's not like we all know that song, is it?
Say to the heart.
And you're to blame. You give dungeon delving a bad name.
Aww.
Well, there's only so fast I can filk it.
She gives bombs a good name. Okay, it's your turn.
Whose turn?
Oh, mine. Yours?
Yeah.
Okay, 5, 10, I think one diagonal is 15.
One diagonal is 5, but two diagonals is 15.
15. So 15 would put me on top of Aaron M.
Mm-hmm.
Can I go straight from there?
Yeah.
So that would put me about there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And that's 35 feet.
So, yeah, you could try and just hit him in the face with a bomb. But you would still take a penalty to your throw because of it being outside your range increment. Or you could try and throw one here and get both of them.
I'll try to throw one there.
Okay.
Yeah.
But... possibility, if I miss, at least, it, I don't know. If and it's incendiary, they might have to go through it anyway. So, what do I roll on this?
Your ranged attack minus... what is it for each range? Minus two?
Two.
Yeah.
Minus two.
Strongarm, supple wrist. I just roll my attack, right?
Oh, yeah, isn't like if you move a certain amount... No, it's a charge, isn't it, I think, with that?
For what? Oh, for throwing increment?
Oh, wait, no, it's not, no, I was thinking of a different thing, not strong arms, supple wrist, that's different. I was thinking of run-up, like, there's one that you get a bonus if you move before you throw. Mm-hmm. It's like a run-up. But I think that has to be like a charge attack throw.
I have no clue.
But yeah, just throw.
I mean, it's targeting.
Roll my standard attack.
Standard attack minus two. Yep, you beat the floor's AC of five. Now they need to try and make reflex saves, or at least the they're both flat-footed, so would they even get to do that? No, it denies a dexterity bonus, but I think they can still make saves. Yeah.
Yay! I can outfight the floor.
The most difficult enemy in Ultima.
Yeah.
Did you attack the floor?
I forget, what's the DC to take half damage from your splash damage again? Well, he didn't do it, and neither did he, so yeah. They both take full damage, so they just take minimum damage still.
It's probably the same formula of like 10 plus half level plus relevant modifier. Ability bonus,
yeah.
Which I think is int in her case.
Yeah. Okay, so what is your minimum damage for your bombs?
1d6 plus 4 plus 1.
So 6 is the damage they both take.
Yeah, splash damage is always minimum damage.
Yeah.
Okay.
They are both bloodied, more so than they were before. It's sort of like, you know, the left-hand side of this guy, the left-hand side of this girl is kind of missing a lot of flesh. And this, now that this...
left-hand side of each could be just missing.
This zombie's like, whoa. And this zombie seeing the explosion is like, whoa. And the zombie hearing the explosion is also like, whoa.
Abomination off in the corridor is like, what's up?
What's happening?
He's like, still he's running. Like, he doesn't want to be fuddly.
Alright.
Guys, I think I got their attention.
Good for you.
And then suddenly, they all start doing the thriller dance. Finally, people are concerned. Finally, people are here to hear our stage show.
Oh, we don't give a damn to the stones that already.
Yeah.
Oh God! Why do they have bombs instead of tomatoes?
Because tomatoes are so last chapter. Besides, if you're gonna bomb, use real bombs. Unless you're throwing them at us.
If you have to fight, clash.
Exactly.
Tuffy? What's Tuffy doing? What can Tuffy do?
Pretty much move into the room. Because she has to double move just to get in here. So she's like, come on, Bruiser. We're hitting only one square behind her because... And while she moves, she prepared her short bow. What is Bruiser's move speed? Let's see. Because maybe he could have done something more. No. Rising Phoenix! Da-da-da-da-da! Okay, so five. 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 30. I miscounted that. Let's see. So there. 10. Yep. She's not going to move all that way, but she's just going to be a couple of steps ahead and be like, have her great axe ready.
Damn it, Aranom! You only did one damage and you got in the way of charging.
She's holding action to swing at anything that comes close.
Yeah.
You see her, she's got her like her axe is like held back, ready to swing.
Or you can do what Rising Phoenix did and just move one move and then ready an action to attack, but I don't know if you can get far enough to make that worthwhile.
Put me there, I think.
You'll...
Because my move speed is 20, so...
Oh, it's only 20.
Okay, so you could move there, yes, but it would be... You wouldn't better hold an action because that would be both your move action and your standard action as a move action.
They don't get initiative this round anyway, so.
Alright.
Zambiz. Alright, so. Just moving forward.
Alright.
Come at me, Zambiz!
Come on, inside. 30, so I'll move 30 up to here, and then I'll yell at Sageheart to duck and take, you know, focus fire on the white one.
Sageheart, duck! Quack. No! The other duck!
Quack? No!
Quack! And we're still alive!
Yep. And 15.
Such a beautiful creature.
Quack!
I'm just listening to the majestic space duck. I never tried Dodoria before, but at least in front of the abridged voice is pretty easy to do for Dodoria, because it's just a deep voice.
Mm-hmm.
I like kids. They don't make much of a mess.
Did it hit?
What the hell? There we go. Did you hit the zombie? Yes.
Okay. Oop. Oh god, that went crazy.
Yeah, it did. 7 damage. Or at least it should be.
Unless they have damage resistance against it's bludgeoning.
Your pebble hits it in the face and it just goes
Ow.
You notice your pebble just lodges in its one of its eye sockets and it just doesn't seem to mind.
Roll. Now the zombie's pulling its head to make that noise.
Make stop. Please make stop. First couldn't get song out of head, now have own drum kit in head.
I just want to bang on the drums all day. Hey, Tom has moved to have a clear shot. And let me measure the distance to make sure it's within short bow range. It is.
Oh, I forgot something. Okay. I forgot to read now his recharge.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, 20 plus 5. Bleesh.
You hit.
And you were attacking this one? What happened? Oh, he dropped.
Oh, did he? Shit.
That's what it looks like.
Well, shit. Now I'll get back to telling you Wild's voted the most feminine and beautiful of the entire race. So what happened to Ben? Did his computer crash or what?
His phone's ringing.
Oh.
Someone's is.
I'm guessing he crashed.
Hello?
Hello.
Hey.
Hello.
Okay, did I actually make that shot or not?
You made the shot, yeah.
Okay. Now I gotta look up the bow's damage.
Okay, we don't have any medic drill anymore, but a shitload of birds just perched on your window, apparently.
Alright, it's a straight up
D6. Get out of here! Why? Sorry, I just lost it when I got on my popcorn.
Quiet down, please. Thank you.
Yes, dear.
Did all of 2 damage.
You shoot the zombie with its arrow, and it goes squish into a bit of necrotic flesh, and he doesn't seem to mind. Well, that's just not very nice. This zombie is just shambling back into the room to see what's going on. Hey, guys.
Hey, guys.
What? Oh. Hey, it's... What are they called again? People. No, no, the other thing. Food. Yeah, food.
He's new.
He just transferred to this room from down the hall. His name's Tom.
Oh, yes, the other one's named Bob?
Maybe. This guy shambles forward. And that's what he does.
Bye.
What you be looking at?
Oops.
You can't see those with this armor!
Hey, bada 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 swing!
Oh god!
That's a hit. Funny enough. Zombie comes up to Raising Phoenix and gets an axe to the face.
Stunk!
8 damage. There was one zombie there, and now there's 2, and neither of them are moving. She just brings it from behind herself, swings up, and just cuts it diagonally in half.
Nice.
Hell, with like how Rising Phoenix is kind of... I kind of imagined her swinging like the characters in Monster Hunter Swing. You know, just big fucking whoosh! Whoosh! but she also manages to pull off like some ways of holding stuff that you wouldn't think usually works, but because like every joint is double jointed, she can pull it off. Okay, so that zombie died. This zombie. 5, 10, 15, 20.
Gains.
Maybe if I get closer to it, then I can make my stuff work better. Okay, let's try this again. Staff of Force! The zombie just goes, ugh, as he gets hit by the bolt of force. Seizures. Aranam gets to be more useful and intelligent when he's got his player here. For now, he's just... Because I don't want to try and figure out which spells he uses, basically, when he is here.
The only one I remember regularly is the summoning spell.
You know, I bet if you put a bomb right there, it'd hit both zombies. Same with right there, actually.
Scoot, hang on.
Either way, you hit two zombies.
Mm-hmm. Let me scoot over one here. And then try throwing the bomb right about here. See if it'll hit all three.
Oh no, you aim for a square. And then square. It does 5 foot. Okay, so yes, that'll hit two of them.
Yeah, well, at least that way we're not hitting the party.
You're aiming for a square, so it doesn't really matter, but you are still slightly outside your range increment, if I counted correctly. 20, 25, yeah.
Yeah, so take 5 foot step forward.
Oh, okay.
And it still counts as a 5 foot step because it's within that range.
Well, no, I'm just saying that's part of her move action that she took. Because you can't
move
and then 5 foot
step.
Yeah.
Well, what I'm saying is, instead of 5 foot stepping from there, she 5 foot step from there to there.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So rolling. 1d20 plus 4 plus 1. And that would be 6 damage, because minimum. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's hot in here. Hot.
Tuffy pulls back the string of her short bow and fires.
Nice.
Crap. When the teabag's broke.
Did the same crap damage that I did.
Yeah, the arrow seems to do bugger all to the zombie. I don't think this is working.
It's still 2 damage.
Well, no, I think Tuffy's saying that I don't think that that's doing any damage at all.
Piercing weapons, they should work on zombies.
They work when they're strong enough.
Oh, it was only skeletons that had an immunity to piercing weapons.
It's not immunity. Don't know, just spreading that out.
Damage reduction.
Stop trying to metagame!
Well, hopefully Phoenix will take care of this one as well.
Rising Phoenix is just like, yep, my axe seemed to work just fine, so I'm gonna use that. Uh oh.
Hey, it's the same shit that happened to me last time.
She was the main control of her weapon.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that a reroll?
No, it's when it's a nat 20 that it's a reroll.
Oh, okay.
Because that's how I'm playing it. If you have a crit fail, and then you critical your crit fail confirm roll, then you get to just reroll.
Okay.
That was fucking hilarious.
It's like you recover from your miss so quickly that you magically quickly turn it around and have another go.
Yeah.
Try and make it look like you meant to do that, you know?
Jen, you can do it!
Sweating.
Be outrageous!
Really? Really? See, would I even... Yeah, I'm gonna do it. Power attack! Fucking it!
Whiff.
How did I miss?
It's just standing there, staring at your chest plate. How'd you miss?
I don't know!
As you swing, he kind of just... As zombies do, just suddenly seems to, like... His weight seems to shift and his legs stumble when he kind of moves out of the way. You know how zombies sometimes just forget to use that leg, so they just like, oh, wait, better use that leg, and end up just stumbling to one side.
And lurching, yeah.
Yeah.
Genevieve's nose just twitches because it's like, I missed. It's not supposed to happen.
Alright. Let's see. Well, noticing that my sling didn't seem to do much, and Tuffy's bow didn't seem to do much, which leaves me with pretty much zero options.
Go Jedi with your quarterstaff.
that wouldn't do much.
Here's a good idea. Close datum and do something with up close with a zombie. Great idea.
I mean, I might do that just to amuse myself, but...
Why not just go up
and... At the moment, there's really... not much I can do.
Here's an idea. Try and use your sling to strangle the zombie.
Will that even work?
I don't think they breathe.
I don't know. It might kill the dead. What?
Yeah, I'm just kind of going to keep an eye out for if somebody needs healing or something.
Probably a wise idea.
For this turn.
By the way, Ben, Tom would have recovered his missing hit points from yesterday.
Oh.
Oh, I completely forgot about Bruiser. Oh, well, next time. Like Rising Phoenix, like, he overhears you kind of talking about how things are ineffective, and she goes back and looks at her bloody axe and just goes, axe work good. But not quite that stupid, you know.
Okay, it's within my move distance. But the question is, can I swap weapons, move, and still attack?
You can drop your weapon. Yeah. And then draw the other weapon as a move, part of your move.
Yep. As long as you have at least a plus one BAB, which I think everybody does.
And he's going to drop the short bow, draw the katana, Move 20 feet. And if possible, attack the Zermdor.
Attack away!
Okay, let me see what my roll is. Three. Yes. Katana for the lose.
Yeah, the zombie lurches to the side and you miss.
Been rolling poorly all day. At least the melee fighters are in melee, though.
Zombie. Because stupid. Other zombie. Now that he's managed to actually stop himself from falling over, now that he actually came to a stop, because shambling momentum is so hard to deal with when you're a zombie. He, like, lifts his arms up and tries to slam down on Genevieve.
Oops.
Clang.
Me give you hug.
Like, the fist, like, his arms come down and just sort of kind of, like, go kind of jelly where they slam into the shield. Just, meh. Ah, I don't want to bend that way.
We won't give you a hug.
I'm gonna hit Rising Phoenix. I don't know how I know their name, but that's what I'm gonna do. And
no,
fail.
Not.
It just kind of like slams its arms against the shaft of her great axe and just completely ineffective.
Did you ever do the roll for Aranam's staff for the second attack?
Oh no, I didn't. Thanks for the reminder. Okay, so he can't use it this turn. All right, let's have a look at his sheet.
What did the third zombie do?
He tried to hit Rising Phoenix and failed.
Oh, two of them tried to hit Phoenix.
Okay. No, one tried to hit Genevieve, one tried to hit Rising Phoenix. The other one just moved.
Oh. What?
They're zombies.
Oh, okay, I'm the center one. Okay, you're a derp.
Yeah. They're shambling, so pretty much they can only move or attack, not both. They're permanently staggered, I think it's called. Well, you guys seem to have this handled.
Give me a minute. I seem to have spent myself.
My staff seems to, my staff needs a bit of time to recover.
Pretty much anywhere behind the front lines will hit at least two zombies.
Unfortunately, no hitting all three of them.
Yeah.
I'm gonna just try and bowl a bomb under one of the zombies' legs.
Although, don't directly try to attack any of them, then you'll hit us, your teammates, with splash damage.
Sageheart, it be your turn.
I don't know. It sounds like a wonderful idea to be.
Oh, God.
Let's see. If I hit the one that's in the column right in front of me, that risks you two getting splash damage, right?
Yeah. So if you just go one square behind it, then it will hit both.
Yeah, but I can probably heal the splash damage. Oh well, I guess I don't do that much damage with bombs, so... Yeah, max 11, so yeah, I might as well just throw for the spot behind.
Yeah.
I should have hit you guys. That's it.
You managed to get it on square.
It has an armor class of 5.
Oh, okay.
It's only crit failing that can make you fuck up throwing it a square, pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good. The floor's a tough opponent this time. 6 damage to the zombies, though.
Don't they still get a reflex save?
Oh, yeah, they do. They get to try and...
Zombies have reflexes?
Splash reflex DC 15.
Oh, you got that right written down. Fair enough. Holy shit, they both take half damage. they don't have a reflex bonus.
What are they doing, the Thriller dance?
Apparently.
So this one takes 3 damage and still dies. This one takes 3 damage. So yeah. One of the men.
Unfortunately, Tom is now blocking Tuffy's shot.
Let's see,
Tuffy can move diagonally 1 square, though. If she's still wanting to arrow it.
Yeah, Tuffy's gonna drop her short bow and draw her short sword on the way over. Oh, damn. Aw, she doesn't confirm. Oh well, she still does D6 plus 4. So Tuffy's short sword gives the zombie a nice trim around the neckline and kills it by lopping its head off.
Ooh. Yeah, that worked better.
And time for the last one to die.
Nope. She missed.
Alright, if neither Phoenix or Jen managed to even hit this one, I...
Use your 3 hands on me. Done! And leave.
Hey, at least I'm pulling my weight this time.
Oh, goddammit, Bruiser. Nah, screw it.
Wondering if I should just do No, I'll do a power attack.
You hit!
Yay. Huzzah! Damage...
With your longsword?
Ah.
Yeah, so that plus 2 power attack.
It's dead.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da!
You have slain the zombie quartet.
I did nothing! Yay!
I did almost nothing!
You stayed out of trouble! That's what you did.
Well, I mean, don't have a lot I can do if they're not, if they're resilient against the sling and bow.
I'm getting. Ooh! I'm searching their bodies. What do I find?
Their bodies? You find, actually, you rolled above a 20. Let's see. It's, you don't see anything on their bodies, but you notice that, there seems to be something, odd about the fountain on the southern wall.
Notice what on the southern wall?
Something odd about the fountain on the southern wall of this room.
Okay, I'm gonna go check it out.
Okay. It's there.
And I'm gonna take 20, observing it. Being very careful now.
Okay. You notice that the flow of the water coming out of this fountain is not as smooth as the previous one. And the water is coming out of the mouth of the sculpture in a very erratic way, as if it was being disturbed on the way down. And because of your taking 20 on it, you eventually realize, oh, there's something jamming the pipe. That's what's making the water come out all weird.
Okay. Gonna use a kunai as a tool to see what's jamming it. Better that than reaching in blindly.
Something bites on the kunai. No. Okay, let's see. Okay. Okay, so I need to roll a thing to see what category you find. Random rolls. GM roll D100.
Good old percentile dice.
Okay, let's see. And
you find a fish corpse. How did it get stuck in there?
Okay, let's go for a one of these.
You find a severed hand.
Wait, no, it's just thing.
Okay, and another one. Okay. So none of that. And wait, where's the table that switches between those ones? There, oh, they removed that. Like, there was a percentile table for what level you find. But now it's just split up randomly. But you're still reasonably low level, so I'll just start on this table.
You find a disgusting mass of zombie flesh. I mean, what did you expect to find?
Okay. You find one more D100.
You find a D100. Woohoo! Oh, sorry.
Wow, a D100. Hey, We get a few more dice and we could actually play a game.
What would we play? Papers and paychecks?
Yeah. Make a reflex save.
Look what my reflex is. Seven. Fuck you!
Your kunai touches something metal, and through the metal of your kunai, you get electrocuted.
Ow.
That is until the source of the electricity actually dislodges and falls into the water in front of you. You take just d6 damage, so 4. And before you, believe it or not, is what looks like a katana.
Grab it out.
You carefully fish it out by the handle to make sure that you don't have any hit any of the conductive points.
Very carefully, because it's in the water.
Yeah.
What a shocking development.
Goes with your electric personality.
Indeed.
Okay, so do you just grab the katana by the handle?
Yeah.
You notice that the end, like the pommel, is blank. Like you see there's some form of insignia on there. On the pommel.
Uh-huh.
And the handguard is extremely plain.
Really?
And then, in your head, or at least you think so, you hear a voice. Name your clan and your master.
I am of the clan of the dragon. And whatever the fuck his master's name is. Because I don't think we ever established that.
I don't think we did, no. He was just sensei, or whatever. You feel a tingling, like that tingling from just after being electrocuted, run down your arm. And into your very core. This is the truth. You are worthy.
Can't hear you.
Oh, can you? Okay.
Okay, I can hear you better now, but...
Okay, yeah, well, I was just kind of whispering for the effect. The blade literally goes... In which the insignia of your clan just suddenly forms on the pommel of the blade, and the handguard becomes a serpent dragon eating its own tail to make a circle. Or it could be the two dragons, yin and yang style. Yeah, let's go with the two dragons. And you can now feel, like, that tingling's gone, and the blade of the katana crackles. And what you have found...
I'm never getting this thing.
And it's quite clearly magical, and involves some form of electricity, but beyond that, you can't seem to know, as it were. Without okay. checking it first.
That's the appraise skill, isn't it?
It would be Spellcraft.
Spellcraft?
Mm-hmm. Appraise is for value, Spellcraft is for identifying enchantments and stuff.
Yeah, I don't have anything in spellcraft.
You also see that, having fallen out with the katana, there is a note in the water.
Fishing out the note and reading it.
It's pretty heavily water damaged.
Yeah, so holding it under the water and reading it's probably the best idea.
Yeah, okay. It reads, the pit has been sealed, and these creatures are greater in number than I expected. I will not join their ranks. To whoever finds this, please tell my clan that I'm sorry that I failed.
Is there any insignia attached to it?
There's a serpent.
Okay, he's going to very carefully roll that up underwater and put it into one of his carry tubes.
Okay.
Which will also be filled with water to preserve it.
Okay. So you managed to collect it, and you now have... and where the... Like, you know where the blade meets the handle? There's usually just a very plain kind of ring where it joins. Mm-hmm. That's like a dragon's mouth with the blade coming out of it.
Yeah, not ever getting rid of the sword.
It wasn't like that until after it asked what your clan was.
Even so.
Yeah.
It's an intelligent sword that changed itself into something to fully resemble my clan. Mm-hmm. Never getting rid of this blade, ever.
Okay.
So, I will put the katana into the scabbard of my old katana, and put my old katana into the fountain. As in, jam it straight into it.
Okay. Well then, now you have that. You could see if anyone else can identify what it does, but that's up to you.
That's gonna wait for a break.
Okie dokie. So you're leaving your old katana there is kind of homage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Homage replacement, something like that.
A ninja gave their life to help me out, so I'm basically giving them a memorial.
Hey, Tom, I think you dropped your katana. Wait, you have another one.
Yes.
I think you need healed, is what I think you need.
Oh yeah, that did look slightly painful.
It was, but it was worth it.
You in need of any healing?
A small amount.
Might want to wait then. You never want to waste healing. Especially in a place like this.
He's hurt.
Considering he's one of our better fighters, I don't think it's waste. Oh, that's me.
Apparently there were more monsters in here than one of our predecessors realized. This was that person's last stand.
I'll see if I've got anything that might work for healing him.
You have your bombs.
Oh god.
Well, sure.
I could try lay
hold
on
still,
hands.
Tom.
Lay on hands might be the best because it's the least amount of damage healing per use of us, and he only needs a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
This is out of character, of course.
Let's go up to Tom and go, hey Tom, boop.
Good game.
Yeah.
Nice. How many times per day can you use that?
6, I believe.
Nice.
Well, now it's 5, but yeah.
That adds up to a lot of healing.
It really does. Yeah, because I think both mine and Sage Hearts are the 1d8 plus caster level.
Mm-hmm.
So, probably want to save those. Assuming Sage Heart has infusions prepared.
Well, I've got healing bombs. So that'll probably do 1d6 plus 4 plus 1. If it's the same as any other bomb. And other than that, I have no clue.
You didn't prepare your spells or your potions for the day?
She doesn't know how.
Oh.
Remember, yeah, Pathfinder's new to her.
As an alchemist, you prepare potions at the beginning of the day, like spellcasters prepare spells. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, I figured we were doing that while Tuffy was disarming things.
Yeah,
right.
Or rather, breaking things.
Yeah, because you
so
make
that's when you
infusions, I think they're called. But because you're a Chiyodron, your healing ones can be used by others now that you're level 2.
The healing ones act as infusions. Infusions are the things that can be used by other people, but they're slightly different. Normal infusions stay active until they're used. The healing ones created by a Chirurgeon can be made inert at the beginning of the next day so the alchemist can make new stuff if they want, unlike a regular infusion. It's kind of weird, but you can actually make those potions and then just hand them out to party members in the morning as for like the healing ones if you want to do that, or just save them on yourself. Or just not make healing potions.
Hey, I'm more than willing to make healing potions with them. I just don't know how much they do or if we're to list it.
You're supposed to have, I believe, a list of spells that you can make that you're supposed to make as you, like, as you level up, you pick spells to put into your spellbook, essentially. And those are the ones you can turn into potions.
Yeah,
it's all in your in the class discussion thing.
In the alchemy page, yeah. Oh, brew potion.
Still have no idea where to list them or how much they do.
No, brew potion's actually separate.
Yeah, I'm looking for.
It's in the alchemy supernatural part is where the extracts are listed, like and how that works. They have a formula list that determines what extracts they can create. And so,
try and find that bit. Is it just at the bottom?
The only
page?
Link I have is hang on. There.
Question.
Yep.
May we take a quick break?
Sure.
Thank you.
Yeah, gets 2 first level formulae of his choice plus a number of additional formulae equal to intelligence modifier at each new level. Gains one new formula of any level they can create. Can also add to formula to the book, just like a wizard adds spells to his spell book using the same cost and time requirements. An alchemist can study a wizard spellbook to learn any formula that is equivalent to a spell the spellbook contains. A wizard, however, cannot learn spells from a formula book. Interesting.
There it is. I found it. The formula list.
Oh, yeah.
That's the same link I asked.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, so basically you prepare those.
Yeah.
So
oh, you're supposed to have... Go ahead.
So being the Kyogen, you most likely prepare cure light wounds every day.